Last week, Afro-Blue weaved together an ambitious medley of Janet Jackson hits. But the judges found their arrangement a little too complex to follow.
This was maybe too ambitious. I got a little lost.
The judges keep saying we tend to go over people's heads.
Our rock song this week is American Girl by Tom Petty and the Heartbreakers.
Let's be clear. Right. I don't know anything about them. I don't know this song.
Afro-Blue is not a rock group at all. I think we all have inner rockers, but we're still looking for our rock sound.
Last week, we branched out so far with throwing the stuff that was jazz influenced. It was just kind of too much.
American Girl, we love Tom Petty, right?
How do we bring him to Afro-Blue, though?
I think it's going to be a stretch this week, honestly. It's just not anything we've ever done.
The way we're going to avoid going over people's heads this week is, as opposed to trying to almost compose a new song, we're going to try to keep it close to the original. And kind of make it work for Afro-Blue, but we still got to find that place. It's a struggle.
With this being week 8, the competition is stiff. It's another level now.
We can't go home now. We've just done so much work. We really want to just take it all home.
Adding their refined flavor to a rock throwback, performing American Girl by Tom Petty and the Heartbreakers, here is Afro-Blue.
The top was especially good. I really liked that you were really yourselves with the harmonies. I think the main thing is keep your eye and your ear on the song, what the song's about. I think by throwing in the national anthem bit, I know it had the word American in it, but I don't think it had anything to do with the song, so that kind of lost it a little bit. Danielle, you sounded great. You always sound great. You're one of my favorite singers. Nice work. But yeah, finding your identity versus the accessibility thing. I know that you don't want to underestimate the public, and I really identify with that. People feeling things need to be dumbed down does not need to be dumbed down ever. And I'm glad that you don't do that. However, you don't want to underestimate the power of a simple song. Hang on to a groove, hang on to the song, the meaning of it. Be complex, but make people not know that they just heard that. Nice work as always, you guys.
All right, Sarah.
Well, we are sitting here clearly looking at some of the most talented singers that this show has ever seen. And you guys are really, really, really fantastically talented, and you have to know that. So I enjoyed the performance, but I felt like I didn't exactly see you guys in it. You can't pick apart your technicality. You guys are so skilled, but my favorite performances from you are when you guys are singing your asses off in a way that I feel that you're really connected to the song. I see what you are, and I want to feel it every single time, effortlessly. So, good job, guys. Really good.
Sean, what you think?
I love hearing you guys sing. honestly. Like, you guys' voices are just amazing. But I feel like, you know, in this particular song, because of the fact that it was a rock song, you might have almost been slightly intimidated by it. I'm not sure. I felt like you didn't feel like it related to you. But overall, I always love hearing you sing. Christy, I love your voice. I love all you guys' voices. So when it comes down to arranging, you know, learn how it relates to you.
Nicely said, judges.